Hello, my name is Debbie Reynolds. They call me the Data Diva. Today I want to talk about data privacy and Nvidia's AI software data leak. So Nvidia has a framework called the Nemo framework, and basically what they're doing is creating products that companies will be able to use when they use things like generative AI for maybe things like customer support or banking, chatting, things like that. A group of researchers from a company called Robust Intelligence were able to manipulate the AI to ignore safety constraints. And as a result, the AI was able to throw out personally identifiable information. Currently, Nvidia is in the process of trying to fix the root cause of this issue, but what we're going to see, or what we're going to continue to see, is researchers hammering hard on some of these AI systems to make sure that they're secure and they're not doing things that maybe they shouldn't be doing, especially if you have safeguards that aren't strong enough. And you're, for example, let's say you're using the same AI model, but then you're creating these different tools where maybe that data set should be separated in some way and not together, so that it won't encroach upon maybe doing things that shouldn't be doing, that the AI shouldn't be doing, or giving advice or providing information that it shouldn't be doing. So we're very early yet on the generative AI journey in terms of commercial uses. So I think that we're gonna start to see more segmentation, or more situations where companies will say, you know, instead of me tapping into a corpus, this huge corpus of data, maybe I want a more targeted data set that I'm using, and maybe have responses or have data in some way that it can't actually breach those walls and go into different areas. So I think as we see generative AI, is it going to change really fast? You know, some of the cracks that we're seeing in AI now, I think will get smooth out. There will always be, and I think this is an example of what's called an adversarial AI attack, which is somehow finding a weakness in the AI system and trying to manipulate it in some way to break the system or make it do something that it shouldn't be doing. So I think Nvidia said that they're already trying to address the root cause to this, but I think we'll see a lot more of this going forward. The good thing is that I think the companies that are creating these experiences will be able to maybe rapidly fix some of these issues that are coming up. I'm hoping that they'll be more transparent with those issues, and also more transparent with the limitations of what these AI systems are capable of doing. That's it. Thank you.